Hey, what's up? Happy Sunday night. So, it is Sunday, August 1st. How about that? It's the first Sunday, and it's the 1st of August. Is that cool or what? 5 weeks in this month. So, with today being the 1st, and all the way to the 31st, I have 4 weeks until I am done with my drive to raise supplies for my Do Something kits and life kits, which go out to homeless people and people battling HIV and AIDS. Tonight I was reading some online stuff, and then I went and checked out some blogs that I read quite a bit, and two of them are from people who are actually homeless, and one of which I know very well because we stayed in the same shelter together a couple of times when we could get in. And I actually met her one night riding a bus all night. And we actually went and slept out on the beach. She would catnap for a little while, and then I would stay awake, and then she would fall asleep and I would stay awake, and we just became pretty good friends. And she's on a lot of the same waiting list that I was on, and she's still actually waiting for her apartment. So I keep in really good close contact with her. Anyway, she had put up on her blog tonight that each night there are 73,000 homeless people here in Los Angeles each night. And I was just like, wow. And I'm reading her blog and reading her blog. And towards the end of her blog, she says she thinks it's much more than that. And I just kind of like shook my head in agreement as I was reading it, because I know people who are homeless that do not turn to agencies or help centers or organizations for help because they feel that it is a big waste of time and all they do is dick you around. And for more than 90% of my homelessness, I didn't turn to agencies for support. I just tried to get through it as best I can, because many of the times it was more problems than it was worth. It was jumping through a whole bunch of hurdles to get spoiled food, or to be told, oh, come back in 2 days to take a shower. Or, you know what, we don't have clothes for you. We'll have clothes in a couple weeks. Here's an appointment. Come back in a couple of weeks. Our washing machine is broken. You can't wash clothes today. It was just more of a hassle to turn to them for support. But the first thing they ask you to do when you go to them for support is to fill out this application and this lengthy process where they get federal dollars for actually helping, and they actually do nothing. So I just got to a point to where I was just like, you know what? This is my last resort. This is the last place I'm going to turn to. I'll eat out of a trash can before I come to a place like this to get a meal. I'll wash my clothes in some sink somewhere before I come here to get clothes that are just as dirty, if not more dirty, than the ones I have on. So, the goal was to raise enough supplies to do 600 Do Something and Life Kits, 300 apiece. Now, the Do Something kit goes to people who are homeless, and the Life Kit goes to people who are battling HIV or AIDS. So that was the goal. I mailed out like over 100 letters, and I've been slowly getting the letters back. I've got most of the letters back, and they've all said no. I had a lot of people say, yeah, I'll help. But in the end, it was just a bunch of people leaving comments and a bunch of people just sending emails on my Facebook page and stuff like that, who really had no intention of helping. They just wanted to look good in front of people. So it's been with the help of a few people here from YouTube, a few people who read my blog, and my core group of supporters that I've been able to put together. I think I just blogged 50, but I just got a phone call that someone's going to give me 10 tomorrow, so it's 60. And I don't feel like going back changing the number on my blog, so it's 60. And even though the goal is for 600, I'm just not going to give up until the end of the month. And even at the end of the month, I'm not going to give up. I'm just going to keep going and try to keep continuing to raise the supplies in order to help people as much as I possibly can. Somebody recently asked me where I get my energy, what's my motivation, what keeps me going. And somebody else said, you know what, you're not paid for this, and this is your time and everything. What keeps you going? And the fact of the matter is, I was once homeless. I was homeless for 29 months, and had it not been for my two best friends, Andy and Tina, and my friends Ryan and Moina, Eric and Willow, Patrick and Crystal, there were times when I just would have given up. It was in those times that they would call and say, hey, Kenji, where are you? Come spend the night with us. Let us take you out to dinner. Let us get you something to eat. Let us get you some clean clothes. Let us wash your clothes. Come chill here and rest. It was just them always motivating me and refusing to let me give up. And that, combined with the way I was raised by great parents, and my faith and belief in myself, that got me through those 29 months. And I know there's people that are going to say, well, I don't give homeless people money, and I don't help homeless people because A, B, C, D, E, F, G, H, I, J, K, L, M, N, O, P, blah, 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 blah. Well, I can make excuses as to why I walk by somebody, or as to why I ignore people until the cows come home. And the bottom line is, the problem is still there. And I would much rather be part of the solution than part of a problem. And I think when we make excuses as to why we won't do something, it's simply because we either know that one day we could find ourselves in that position, or we just don't give a damn about anybody besides ourselves. And that, both points are pretty sad. So I want to say thanks to everybody who has reached out so far and kept their word and helped with donations. Just recently, I had somebody, really cool person who I just started watching her videos a couple months ago, reach out to me, and she's like, you know what, it's not much, but I want to send some clothes. And I just smiled, because I was just like, it's so much, it is a lot. Even if it's just a blouse or a shirt or a pair of jeans, that's a blouse, a shirt, or a pair of jeans that I didn't have to actually go out and give to somebody. So it doesn't take a lot to help people. It takes people showing up and giving from their heart and expecting nothing in return. So when people ask me, where do I get my motivation, my drive, my energy, how has this become my passion? It's because, I mean, people say that I'm so inspiring, and I always turn right back around and I look at people who bring clothes. I look at people who buy water, who help me purchase food, who help me do what I do, and they are the inspiration for me. They are the huge inspiration for me to keep doing what I'm doing, despite all the criticism, despite all the negative feedback, and despite all the haters out there. No matter what you do in this life, there's always going to be a critic. There's always going to be somebody that tries to come against what it is you're trying to do. And I just say, you know what, walk on your own path and live your own purpose. And I think a lot of times people attack things that they don't understand. It's because they have no direction in their life. They don't know what their life is all about. So it's easy to just go around and attack people for who are actually trying to make change, who are actually doing everything they can to make this world a better place, this city a better place, this town a better place, wherever it is you are. It's so easy for somebody to sit back and criticize that when they sit their nasty asses on the couch and troll around YouTube making nasty comments, or even in their daily life just running around talking garbage about somebody. Nana used to always say, consider the source. And sometimes when I get nasty feedback and nasty comments or really rude remarks towards me or what I do. I just take a good hard look at the person or the source from whence the comment came, and I'm just like, look at your life. Look at your situation. No wonder you're trying to attack me, because you're trying to take all the energy off the crap that's in your life. So that's it. It's not over until it's over. And I'm just going to keep working and keep moving forward and doing everything I can to help people. So I posted my first blog in a long, long time, and I'm really excited about that. And there's some pictures on the blog from, I'm calling them Out My Window. So if you want to check out the blog, there is a link down there. All right. Bye, guys.
Peace.